Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I'm super excited for today's video because we're entering a new chapter of my channel in multiple ways. It's my first recommendation video, my first video about boys' love, and my first featuring webtoons. I know, it's a lot to take in all at once. Because it's my first video like this, I wanted to spend a bit of time setting the scene before we get started. I've been a fan of both webtoons and the boys' love genre for a while now, but this summer is when I really dove in. Webtoons actually make up the majority of my reading these days, and I've been having a lot of fun exploring boys' love. So I wanted to spread that joy today and share some of the series that I can't get enough of. It was hard narrowing my choices down, but I tried to curate a somewhat diverse list in terms of the age of the characters, the subject matter, and spiciness. If you can believe it, I originally had 15 titles that I was absolutely set on talking about, but I figured it's probably best to start off small. So this video will feature 6 webtoons across 3 platforms. Without further ado, let's get started. I'm going to start off with the Safe for Work series. I'm not sure if I need to mention this, but just in case. Even for the not Safe for Work webtoons, I won't be showing anything explicit in this video, so no need to worry. Up first, we have Hisu in Class 2 by Lily, which is a completed series on Legend Comics. Recently, a rumor has been circulating that anyone who talks to our main character Hisu will be successful in the romantic pursuits. Hisu himself is a really bright and cheerful guy, but because he's often in the background as a listener and a cheerleader, he hasn't had an opportunity to process his own crush on his best friend. One day, one of his classmates, Seung-won, asks to confide in Hisu about his crush, but for a change of pace, he offers to listen to Hisu as well. So in this series, we get to see Hisu finally navigate his feelings, fall in love, and basically experience all of the fun and the butterflies of youth and romance. I can't speak highly enough of this series. It's so fluffy, optimistic, and positive. We're essentially watching characters experience their first loves and gush over their feelings, and it's absolutely perfect. Every single chapter made me feel so warm and fuzzy inside. My chest felt so bubbly and effervescent, which I know sounds a little weird, but I was essentially gushing over how sweet everything is. The characters are all so lovable and so easy to root for, and the relationship is so healthy and fun. Even talking about it right now makes me want to dive back into this wholesome story. And I would recommend this to anyone who enjoys youth, school life, and high school romance, and especially to anyone who needs a warm and soft pick-me-up. Next, we have A Lucky Coin on Papas, which was based on a novel by Wu Zha. The art and the script for the comic adaptation is made by Lucky Animals. Due to an event in their past, Hank and his father are constantly moving around. Hank himself is a high school dropout who often streams as a way to pass time, and since he moves so often, he doesn't really have an opportunity to make meaningful connections. One day, he notices a boy, Junior, getting bullied, and he leaps to his rescue. Junior is shy and can't really speak without stuttering, and while he seems like the complete opposite of the cool and strong-willed Hank, Hank notices that they're actually pretty similar at their core, and he promises to protect Junior. And this is the start of seriously one of the best friendships I've ever read. As we all know, this world is not an easy one to live in, and it's been so touching seeing Hank and Junior slowly overcome their pain and fears together. Hank is the older brother and hero that Junior needs, whereas Junior is what keeps Hank grounded and stops him from slipping too deep into his sadness. In short, they allow each other to sort of forget what's bothering them. And together, both of them can be something more than their situations. Both characters are quite young at the start of the series, at 17 and 14, so there isn't any romance between them. It's more familial, which is totally fine by me. The comic is actually still going on, so I'm curious if there ever will be any romance. But honestly, the story is already so great without it. So I would recommend this to anyone interested in stories that deal with found family, growing up, coping with one's negative environment, and of course, a slow burn. We're now moving on to slightly spicy things, starting with Cherry Blossoms After Winter by Bamu. This is an ongoing series on Tappytoon. Haebom and Taesung are childhood friends, but after the death of Haebom's parents, he moves in with Taesung and his mom. While the two of them used to be really close, due to a miscommunication, they quickly drifted apart and started avoiding each other. Now in their senior year of high school, they become classmates for the first time, and this gives both of them a unique chance to repair their friendship and finally move past their misunderstanding. This series is such a delight. What I appreciate about it is that we get to see Haebom and Taesung grow up together from their childhood all the way to adulthood. And we can see how their relationship also evolves and adapts in the various phases of their lives. It's also nice seeing the same set of characters deal with issues like bullying in high school, but then also later on deal with living on their own and how to maintain a relationship as working adults. I think the fact that it spends a bit of time in each chapter of their life could make it more appealing to more readers. As in, those who like school romance will get their fill, but so will those who want adult romance too. It also makes the story more interesting because we're not stuck in the same setting for too long either. I would recommend this series to anyone who wants an overall straightforward, soft, and wholesome story about growing up. Starting with season 3, when the characters are essentially adults, you can actually read the series in one of two ways. There's the usual safer work or all ages version, but now there's also a mature option. It's of course up to each reader to decide which version to go with, but the mature version includes all the smutty scenes, whereas the all ages version splices those scenes out and leaves it just suggestive instead. With that in mind, depending on which version you choose, Cherry Blossoms After Winter is still a pretty tame series, but the next few recommendations will be flat out explicit with no safer work versions. So, if you're a minor, or if you don't feel comfortable with reading explicit works, thank you for watching up to this point, and I hope any of the previous webtoons piqued your interest. Next, we have BJ Alex by Mingwa, which is a completed series on Legend Comics. Donghyun is a shy and insecure college student. He grew up in a pretty restrictive environment, so he doesn't have a lot of experiences with exploring his sexuality. One of his outlets is to watch the live streams of the charismatic and confident broadcast jockey, BJ Alex. After an incident at a class party, Donghyun finds out that his favorite streamer is actually his class president, Jiwon. And Jiwon is pissed that someone found out his identity. Surprisingly, however, he decides to enter a casual and sexual relationship with Donghyun to help his broadcast. I actually went back and forth about including this series in this video because I actually also go back and forth about how much I like it. I would say this is a pretty typical setup with an emotional and naive guy paired with an arrogant and cold guy. And to be honest, I wasn't a big fan of the power imbalance between the characters. It pained me to see Donghyun suffer and feel confused about his feelings, and of course that left me confused for a while about my thoughts on the series. But I realized that seeing these characters break out of their first impressions, their archetypes, was what made this series interesting. We get to see Donghyun finally break out of his shell, we get to see the different sides of the supposedly indifferent and detached Jiwon. So I ended up liking the series a lot more than I thought I would. BJ Alex has a ton of great smutty scenes, which makes sense since that's what the relationship was founded upon, but it's actually interesting seeing how these moments develop throughout the story as well. The entire webtoon is in black and white, but Mingwa actually makes a point to overlay color in some key intense moments, which I think is a cool way to use art. It's still not my favorite webtoon, but I can't deny that I enjoyed it despite its drawbacks. I would recommend it to anyone who appreciates the power of spicy scenes for sure. But also to anyone who enjoys angst that eventually pays off and character growth. It's definitely a bit of a waiting game, but I'd say it's worth it in the end. Next, we have Paid by Fujo King, which is a completed series on Tappitude. What initially drew me to Paid is actually the setting. Our main character, Hee-jae, is the executive director in his family's business conglomerate. He's mixed up in an embezzlement scheme, and the documents that link him to it are lost and picked up by an accounting student, Taekyung. Hee-jae, of course, does not want this information getting out, so he goes to great lengths to keep Taekyung next to him. He thinks he has the upper hand in this situation, because there's no way a business student should be able to fully understand the documents. But it quickly becomes apparent that there's more to Taekyung than he lets on. As I mentioned, the setting is what drew me in. I love the idea of a story about conspiracies and secrets, and with such high stakes, I couldn't help but keep reading to see what happens next. There's so much drama between the characters, and almost every relationship is more complicated than it seems. I think I'm kind of picky when it comes to smut in comics. In the case of Paid, the explicit scenes didn't stand out to me one way or the other, and I didn't particularly feel anything. I think I was so caught up in the drama that those moments didn't captivate me as much as they could've. Regardless, this series was an enjoyable whirlwind the entire time, and I would recommend it to anyone who enjoys drama and a bit of mystery. Last but certainly not least, we have Momentum by Park Ji-yeon, which is completed on Legend Comics. If there is any series you decide to start today, it has to be Momentum. Momentum is a collection of short stories that follows various couples. There are also various intensities, I'd say. On one end of the spectrum, for example, we have a rather straightforward and all-around fluffy romance between two actors, whereas on the other, it's just pain, pain, and more pain. So with that variety, I'd say this series is a good way to get a taste of all sorts of feelings and settings. While I would still insist that the one webtoon from this video you absolutely have to read is Momentum, if I had to pick one short story within it to recommend, it would have to be Therapist. Therapist haunts me to this day. It tore me into a million pieces and put me back together at the same time. I don't know how to describe this feeling other than to say after reading it, my heart was coated with so many feels for so long, and I honestly have never felt like that while reading anything. I think that's just a testament to how great of a creator Park Ji-yeon is. In just a few chapters, they're able to evoke so much emotion and drama. When you see the characters in intimate moments, the atmosphere is also always so moving and exciting. It's great. You can certainly read the stories as standalone works, but there's a bit of an interconnectedness between them, with some characters from one story appearing as secondary characters in another. So while not necessary, I would recommend checking them out in order if you plan to read them all. And that brings us to the end of this video. I hope you found something here that caught your eye. If you're already a fan of Boys Love, what are some of your favorite series? Manga, dramas, webtoons, whichever medium, I'm always down to check it out. Since this was my first recommendation video, I wanted to play it a bit safe. There are so many amazing Boys Love webtoons out there, so even if just for myself, I do plan on making more videos like this in the future, and maybe hopefully share some lesser known titles too. I also want to make recommendation videos on other genres and other topics, but I'm still trying to figure out the most effective way to do that. Lastly, while my channel is primarily a manga channel, I hope this video can be my first step into incorporating webtoons as well. I do read things outside of Boys Love, so if you ever want to talk about other genres, I would really love that. At one point, I also thought about making a general intro to webtoons, but I figured most people are probably already familiar with them. Regardless, if that's still something you're interested in, do let me know. As always, thank you for taking the time to listen in. I hope you all stay safe, happy, and healthy. See you in my next video.